Winter is coming. And it got me wondering how exactly my little sparrows survived the cold of winter. So I did what I always do when I get curious. I researched it. And I also borrowed my buddy's thermal camera. I hope you're doing well today. Welcome to Koa Nature's Casual Outdoors Weekly, where we go over outdoors activities for you to do for the benefit of your health and happiness. We also knock up our nature smarts a little bit under 6 minutes. And this one's more of a cerebral exercise that we can do while watching our sparrows or other birds on a bench with a nice cup of coffee. For me, I currently have 3 species of sparrows visiting my feeder. The house sparrow and the song sparrow, both of which don't appear to want to migrate further south, and the white-throated sparrow has shown up in the last number of weeks, probably on migrations down from Canada. And even if you loathe house sparrows because they're invasive, murdering mobs that are not good for our native species, let's just accept they're adorable and possibly evil. I want to be a good host, so I offer the birds different seeds on the daily. And unlike most bird feeder owners, I don't mind feeding the eastern gray squirrels because I grew up in Colorado feeding generation after generation of fox squirrels. And we had the fattest fox squirrels on the Front Range. Years ago, I even did my own research on the mutualistic symbiosis that exists between squirrels and birds, where it's evident that as one species calls an alarm warning of a predator, like these cooper hawks that showed up the other day, the squirrels and birds recognize each other's calls, using this information to escape the predators. So having squirrels around your feeder isn't that all bad for your birds. Okay, so how do my little sparrows stay warm during the winter? First, let's remember that birds are warm-blooded like us and like the squirrels. They have to generate their own heat, unlike cold-blooded creatures such as this northern water snake. And little birds like sparrows don't have the capability to store up a lot of fat like bigger birds such as the Canada goose. And we know that a nice layer of fat is a great way to stay warm. These elephant seals definitely know that. But birds have feathers which can be outstretched to make them appear poofy. This traps a layer of air between the feathers and the body of the bird, and the body can warm that air that's trapped in that layer, creating an insulating barrier of warmth between the bird and the cold air. These feathers also produce oils that create a waterproofing effect. If feathers retain too much water, that would prevent flight and pull away too much heat from the body. My Carolina chickadees, which are pretty much always moving, are masters of a technique to stay warm that just involves shivering. These sparrows, besides poofing, need to eat on the regular. Remember that they are generating their own heat and can't store too much fat. The seeds they eat will be consumed in metabolic activity, where a byproduct is heat. Heat that they really need. But they will gain fat weight in the winter to help with lipid reserves to fuel that metabolic activity, and it also adds a tad bit of insulation. Another strategy to stay warm is that the sparrows will group up at night when it gets really cold. They'll do this under dense shrubs or other tight spaces in other nooks, and they'll share warmth with each other away from the harshest of the elements. Another strategy that birds do to stay warm is something called regulated hypothermia. They have the capability to drop their body temperature almost 22 degrees Fahrenheit from what they maintain during the day. And this involves dropping body temperature as well as metabolic activity. So it'll be interesting to see the birds do more poofing during the winter. And I keep going out at night trying to find out where those birds are nesting and doing that grouping bit, but I can't find it. But it's okay. Yesterday, I found the largest spider I've ever found in Virginia. This is a dark fishing spider, and she is gorgeous. Remember that subscribing is always free. Spread some knowledge, be nature heroic, and I hope to see you next Wednesday at 1 p.m. Eastern Time.